Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. This is the third episode of Dr. Pano's experience matching into neurosurgery at the Mayo Clinic. In the first two episodes, we talked about Dr. Pano's medical school experience, the USMLE step scores, the clinical rotations, and the different pathways applicants can take to match into neurosurgery. In this episode, we'll talk about one of the most important factors helping international medical graduates match into competitive specialties, which is research. Dr. Pano, I would like to start by asking you about the value of research and what are the factors that you can do to help you match into neurosurgery or other competitive specialties from research?
Yeah, absolutely. That's a very good question. And I think who you decide to do your research with is one of the most critical components of essentially your journey when you decide to cross the Atlantic and come to the United States. It needs to be done with great care, with great caution. As I did, a lot of people, while they're in med school, you need to do a very good preparation. In my mind, the ideal is that you stay in one place during your research fellowship and you give, you know, your best chances there. The first thing that we need to tell the people out there is not necessarily that is going to happen, but if you decide to take the research pathway, you have to be prepared that you're going to support yourself financially for 1 year, in my mind. And that can be a lot of money. If, for example, you're trying to do research in a place like New York, or let's say San Francisco, or perhaps Houston. The second thing is, once you come here, then as you very correctly said, Mark, and I was exactly in the same position, is your productivity is going to pick up after about 6 to 8 months. Let's say the first 6 months, you're just around, you have no idea, you're in a new place, meeting people, understanding the philosophy and the mindset, you know, and the people you're interacting with, and you're getting to understand how to get things done, right? You have no idea who you're going to talk to, how you're going to submit things, what this, you know, the systems look like. And so adapted into the new environment. And so I think productivity picks up after 6 to 8 months. In the meantime, you can have like a small project to work on. But ultimately, I think you're way more productive during your second year of research than the first year. And that's why I said again, to do probably 2 years of research before you apply. When it comes to research, another very common question that people ask is, what's the best research, you know, to do? How can I be most productive? If you go into the numbers again, I think you'll see that, you know, the international applicants, you know, and because they clump all together into the NRP, meaning publications and abstracts and presentations. And I think for the international senior surgery was about 30 or 40. So that's a, you know, humongous number. And even now, you know, in the American students, that's also something that we have to say out there for people to know, is that because things are getting so competitive, even for the American graduates, for the American students, that even the American students now are taking a year off their med school and they do research, like in neurosurgery, as far as I know.
And the same for plastic. This is something I was also surprised. This is the same thing in plastic surgery. Even American graduates are taking a research year now.
Yeah, so they figured it out now, like this is what's happening. And so this is what they do. And so we have to be prepared and we have to be, you know, ahead of the game if you really want to stand out as yourself. And so what's the best research to do? Obviously, I'm not going to tell, you know, people is, you know, start, you know, doing just systematic reviews and meta-analysis. We have done a lot of them. But, you know, the thing is, in this, you know, ultimately, what you want to tell the program about your research, because they're going to ask you about it and you have to be prepared to talk about it, is whether you can tell a story about, you know, your research and whether you can connect the pieces together that with your research you contributed to the field that you want to, you know, you're going to apply to. And so if you can do this with, you know, the type of research that you did and whatever that is, then, you know, that's great. In my mind, definitely you want to have quality. I do think that, and you know, I may, you know, some people may not, you know, may not agree with me, but I do think that for the research fellowship part of our lives, I do think that quantity matters more than quality. And the reason why I'm saying this is because you want to show that those 2 years you spent, you were productive And that usually, whether we like it or not nowadays, that means numbers of publications. You want to show that you were able to pick up things quickly. You moved from one project to the other, that you work with different people with different projects, and you cut it out, you know, a lot of, you know, you cut it out a lot of different projects. And one other thing is, you know, obviously authorship does, you know, does matter, at least in our institution. They always say, you know, how many, you know, of these publications your first author or second author on. I would tell, you know, people is, even if you get assigned, for example, if let's say you find a paid position in a basic research lab, that you always have some clinical, you know, quick projects that you're going to work with, because ultimately people are going to look into the numbers, whether we like it or not.
That brings us to the end of this episode talking about Dr. Panos research experience. Thank you so much, Dr. Panos, for this extremely insightful information. In the next episode, we'll talk about the MASH experience. So make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next episode or future episodes related to the MASH process, residency, or research in general. If you like the video, hit the like button and share it with your friends and colleagues so they can get an idea of how to MASH into competitive specialties in the US. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Also, feel free to reach out to my Instagram or Twitter accounts at Malki Asad or my Facebook page, Malki Asad MD. Thank you so much, everyone, for watching, and see you in future videos.